a long way away from the season, and a lot of the stuff you're doing isn't quite as football related as what you'll do in the fall. But how do you manage that? Is this a time of year that's difficult for you? How do you get through this cycle?
It's difficult, but also since I'm transferring from a different place right now, I'm just doing school, learning the playbook, and just spending time and like recovering and stuff, getting my body right.
Being able to play for Venables, what attracted you to that, pairing up with him, being coached by a guy like him?
Since like his mindset is defense, so that was like a no-brainer. I'm like, I want to come here and like compete for him.
And your early impressions of Zach so far, and what he's going to bring to the program?
Who's that?
Zach Alley.
Oh, Coach Alley?
Coach Alley.
He's a really good coach. Everyone is liking him so far. So like, I like how he's like talking to us as a defense. How like he's adding package on like the defense and stuff. So like how he's like gonna help us a lot down the road.
Okay, man, being here.
Mm-hmm. What's going on?
I'm in kind of a full circle moment.
Yeah.
Obviously, from camping here in June of 21 to being a senior.
Mm-hmm.
How good does it feel just to finally wear that crimson and cream, wear that logo on your chest?
Man, it feels crazy. It feels like this is where I should have been like starting to begin with, honestly. But overall, it's been really good just to like come back and see everything and also compete in front of everybody from Oklahoma, my family and everything. So yeah, it's been really good.
Who are some of the older guys that have made an impression on you so far, whether personally or just from a football standpoint?
The one off the top of the head is Woody. He's helped me a lot. Just like teaching me how like OU is being ran and everything, and like how like just like overall everything.
That's good.
Mm-hmm.
That's good.
And I've learned a lot from like Kendall Dobie and everything, just like his mindset, how you approach like every single day, and just like his work ethic.
How do you feel the support from the top down, the coaching staff, not just at your position with Coach Vali, but everybody coming around you, being there if you need it? Like how much do you feel the holistic support as a whole coming from the coaching staff?
I feel like it's really good. I haven't talked to everybody yet outside of Coach Vali and Coach Venables, but overall I feel like it's really good. Everybody is going the right direction with it. Yeah. So pretty good so far.
How's it been getting acclimated to Schmitty workouts?
Oh, you know how college gets. It's springtime, tough, still trying to get used to everything. But overall, I feel like I'm getting really good with it. Still trying to like learn like how the drills is being ran and everything. But overall, it's been pretty good.
When you hit the transfer portal from Utah, did you know this is where you wanted to be?
Oh, yeah. I knew where I wanted to come. I ain't gonna lie. Because, like, I've been talking to my family. I'm like, I'm trying to come back home. But I didn't know how, like, they would take it. So, yeah. Whenever I told them I was coming back at home, they was like, would you ever want to go to Oklahoma? I'm like, if they give me the opportunity, I would love to. So, yeah.
Now, your little brother has an OU offer, too. What do you think? Think he ends up here as well?
Time will tell.
Yeah?
That's all I got to say. Mm-hmm.
But he's had that relationship with Vali a long while, right? I think even before you.
Yeah.
You were already at Utah. So
yeah, I didn't even know.
Vali can't hit you up when you're at Utah.
Yeah, I didn't know who Coach Vali was. Like, my family would be like, yeah, he went to OU. He talked to Vali. I'm like, who's Vali? I'm like, I don't know who that is. So, yeah, I've, like, learned about Vali from, like, my family and my little brother.
I got you.
Mm-hmm.
What's your experience of him as a coach been?
Coach Vali?
Yeah.
Very intense. Details, focusing on like the small things, on like technique. So it's been really good.
That's cool. On the offensive side of the ball, you see those, and Nigel called them freaks.
Yeah.
At the wide receiver position, man. How much does that excite you for what this team's going to be able to do offensively?
Oh yeah,
this season?
They got some guys over there just ready to go. I'm like super excited just to like go compete against them every single day and get better.
Yeah. I mean, how much do you feel like that can help you going up against a guy who's 6'5" like Jaden Gibson, or a guy who's literally faster than everybody in Brandon Thompson?
Yeah, I feel like it's gonna help me because I'm gonna get to see like every different type of receivers in the group.
Yep.
Like you got Brandon Thompson who runs a 10-3, maybe like 10-1, and then you got Jaden Gibson who's 6'3", 6'4", who can jump, run a route. So I feel like they have different receivers who's like, they have qualities in their game that like you'll be able to see in practice and also make you better.
What do you want to accomplish this year? When you look back on the 2024 season, what boxes do you want to have checked?
I just want to come in and just compete and see where that takes me.
Simple as that?
Just compete.
Mm-hmm. What's your experience of Coach Venables been like?
I haven't talked to him a lot, but yeah, it's been really good, the little time I've gotten to spend with him. So yeah, it's been pretty good.
How excited are you to strap the pads back on next week and get back at it?
I've been ready for that because last spring whenever I was in Utah, I didn't get to do spring because I had shoulder surgery. So like that also held me out of the spring and also fall camp because of my shoulder. I was doing rehab for it every single day. So getting back in the field is going to be really fun and exciting just to get back.
How talented is Billy Bowman?
Yeah, he's really like a coach out there.
Really?
Yeah. Just like his mindset, like he knows so much about the game. I'm like, oh my God, I want to get there someday. Just like knowing what everybody's doing and just like helping everybody around me. So yeah, it's been really good.
Nice, man. Mm-hmm. How do you feel about the secondary as a whole, being able to go into the SEC and lock it down?
I feel like the secondary can be one of the best in the country. We all just got to believe, just have to believe that we can get it done. And we'll be good. We'll be good. Just have the belief that we can get it done.